this video, we're going to be attempting to transform a pair of Nike Huarache Ultras to Nike Huarache Drifts, or at least our own version of them. But first, we'll need to make a rough drawing of how we want the finished product to look. Essentially, what we're going to do is cut part of the cage off and drill some holes into the side to make a lacing system. And I know what you're thinking, hey, won't that just make them look like human races? And the answer is yes. I basically got the inspiration for this custom from them. So for the first step of this custom is to clean off any dirt or grime off the shoe, and for this I'm using a Jason Marks shoe cleaning set, and I've actually put the solution itself in this bottle that pumps it out as foam. So after quickly unlacing both the shoes, we can give them a good clean with brushes and solution. After we're done cleaning, using a microfiber towel to clean off any of the dirt, we can start modifying these. First, I must start off with some scissors, but I soon learned that they don't really work with cutting this cage in particular. They're just not sharp and heavy duty enough. So instead, I use a Stanley knife. That did seem to work after a while of cutting, but I don't think this is going to work very well for the whole cage on these shoes. So my last resort was to use some heavy duty scissors from a sewing set. And to my surprise, these worked out the best of the bunch. So we're definitely going to be using these to cut the cages. If you look back at the drawing, I'm going to cut off most of the top part off. The only real challenge is going to be cutting close to where we want the cage to end and not accidentally cutting the fabric of the shoe. And it's actually much harder than it looks. The scissors are quite big, so it's difficult to get right up next to the edge in order to cut the cage off cleanly. But it is possible, and after I've done that, you can see that the lines don't really have the cleanest cut. So in order to fix that up, we're going to be using a Dremel to sand down the edges. Again, you have to be careful while doing so. So it's best to tape off some areas that you think you might damage in the process. I don't know what this cage is made out of, but it's actually really difficult to sand down. It's almost like it's a mixture of fibers inside which don't really sand down as easily as normal plastic material that you find on normal shoes. But eventually, after a while of sanding, we can see that it's finally sanded down enough to a satisfactory degree. And after sanding down the other bit that the cage was connected to, you can start to see how the shoe is going to look like. And with the magic of editing, we'll skip through doing the other side and bang, this is how the shoes look before and after. Skipping even more ahead, bang, this is how each shoe looks with the cages successfully chopped off and dremeled down. They do look pretty clean, you know. Next, we'll have to drill a hole for the laces to lace into, and thankfully this time, the cage area we're drilling the hole into is made of a more standard plastic you find on shoes, and it's way easier to work with. I'm just using the ruler as support for behind so I don't drill into the fabric of the shoe. A quick test to see if the laces fit in our initial holes, and indeed they do. We'll just clean up the edges of the holes with these small shears or whatever they are. And that is the first set of lace holes done. I'll do the rest of them off camera and I'll show you how they look now. They've actually come out hella clean. Even if you didn't do the best job for the lace holes, you wouldn't really be able to tell since you're going to have the laces going through them anyway. Next, we move on to the painting segment for these customs. Now, the color of the shoe is already actually looking quite clean, so I'm not going to do that much to it. Before we start painting, we're going to use some acetone to strip off the finish on the cages. Next, we take a small paintbrush and use some flat black paint to paint in the areas that I plan to paint in the sketch. I do two coats of this paint so that the color underneath won't show. And after we're done with that, I just use some matte acrylic finisher on top to seal the deal. I actually did think of painting the areas we cut the cages from, but I thought they would look better in the dark green that's already on the shoe and not black. And unfortunately, I don't have any of that dark green to paint with. So we're just going to leave it how it is. I always like to sign my work when I'm done. So for that, I'm just going to use a Sharpie to write my signature at the back underneath the Nike logo. And I like how it's sort of hidden in the dark green, so you only notice it if you're looking at that spot specifically. After I lace up the first shoe, we can see how much better it looks like with laces, or to me at least. I don't know, it just feels a bit empty without them. And just before I show you these babies on feet, I spray them down with some Jason Mark Repel to prevent them from getting dirty easily. And now they are ready to wear. Alright, let me know if you guys like these or if you do something differently. Thank you so much for watching and stay blessed.